Much for playing my game.
Mario, and these are the formulas for the path calculations. These calculations must be done per hop in the angle covered formula. Latitude and longitude must be converted first from degree, minutes, seconds, to decimal degrees. A means first location, while B means second location. For the total path distance, R means the radius of the Earth at sea level. at the equator in kilometers equal to 600,378.137. For the minimum elevation, h equals to dm squared over 12.75 k, where k equals to 4 thirds, h equals to kilometers, and dm equals to meters. For the earth curvature equals to d1 times d2 over 12.75 times k, where k equals to 4 thirds, d1 equals to distance 1, and distance 2 equals to d2, and d1 and d. Ground elevation is equals to path elevation plus earth curvature, and these are all in meters. Tower height, d is equal to the total distance from location 1 to location 2 in kilometers. H is equals to the Fresnel radius of distance 1. HO is equal to the highest height of obstruction. H2 equals to distance with the highest path elevation. D2 equals to height of the previous antenna, while PE equals the highest path elevation. For the line of sight, theta should be first solved to find L of S. H1 and H2 are height of antenna A and in meters. E1 and E2 are the path elevation of A and B in meters. D2 equals to the distance from side B. And D is equal to the total distance in kilometers. For the Fresnel radius, distances are in kilometer and the operating frequency in gigahertz. Reflection points, heights and distances from the reflective areas in meters and kilometers. Reflection points should pass through or under the Fresnel zone. The reflection point should never be equal to the Fresnel zone. So this is for the link budget. These are the formulas for the attenuation. This calculation must be done per hop and must be calculated in high band and low band frequencies. For the pre-space path loss, FSL dB is equals to 92.4 plus 20 log F gigahertz plus 20 log D kilometers. Don't forget that this given formula is applicable only if the given frequency is in gigahertz and the given distance is in kilometers. The resulting unit for calculating FSL is in dB. For the atmospheric losses, for the oxygen absorption loss, AO equals to quantity 7.19 times 10 raised to negative 3 plus 6.09 over F squared plus 0.227 plus 4.81 over F minus 57 squared plus 1.5 quantity times F squared times 10 raised to negative 3. And don't forget that F is in gigahertz, while the answer is in dB. For the atmospheric losses, water vapor absorption loss. Mamma mia! This is a long formula. AH2O equals 2 bracket 0.067 plus 3 over parenthesis F minus 22.3 parenthesis squared plus 7.3 plus 9 over parenthesis f minus 183.3 parenthesis squared plus 6 plus 43 4.3 divided by parenthesis f minus 323.8 parenthesis squared plus 10 parenthesis f squared times a times 10 raised to negative 4. For the rain attenuation, losses which are specially prevalent at frequencies above 11 GHz. To calculate the rain attenuation, we need to know first, latitude and longitude of the Earth station to within a degree. Second, altitude of the station in kilometers. Third, the frequency of operation. Fourth, the polarization of the signal. And lastly, the required availability of the satellite circuit. The depth of rain, which is L rain, where L rain is the rain loss in dB, while gamma R is the specific attenuation, dB per kilometer. D rain is the path length through the troposphere in kilometers. Determining D rain is effectively the slant range of the proportion of the signal that lies below the freezing point, which is the 0-degree isotherm in the atmosphere. The assumption is that all rain originates at this level. Thank you. This implies knowledge of the rain height, H rain. ITUR recommendation, P.839 relates rain height to location. It is reproduced at table 1 as you can see here. We can observe here in the picture. Identify the rainfall region. The Philippines is in the N region. This gives the value of the rainfall rate R, which can be used to determine gamma R. You can see in the table. Table of coefficient for K and alpha as you can see in the picture. If circular polarization is to be used, then calculate the average value of gamma R for vertical and horizontal polarization should be used. For the transmission line loss, under the transmission line loss, we have the branching loss, also known as the connector loss, equal to 5 dB. Transmission line loss for receiver and transmitter is found in the specification sheet. For the total system loss, total system loss is the overall combination of losses. This include free space loss, transmission line losses, branching loss, antenna misalignment, and atmospheric losses, under which we have oxygen absorption loss and water vapor absorption loss.
Huh? Hey guys, where's Mario?
Yeah, where is he?
I think that was him.
Mario!
Blooper time!
Okay guys, take one. Mario, are you ready?
One third the life, what the fuck?
What's that for? Yeah.
Sorry, again.
I will fix that.
Little question, guys. Can you give me some normal enemies? Are you gonna change that one third life?
Okay, just a second.
No!
spaghetti. Ah, ravioli.
So wake up, you silly.
Uno momento. Whoa, you gave me 3 lives.
Duh, do you think I'm stupid?
Yes, I do. Lives? But then I used to be dead.
Oops, sorry Mario. The explosion took 3 lives from you.
Just shut up, you son of a...
Hello, this is again Mario. And after the video break, we will come back to the system gain of the microwave link. This will be used to counter all the attenuation or the negative part that will degrade the signal. A little reminder for all of you. You will do this for every hop. And for a high band and low band frequency. So in our project, we do it in a 3 hops process. The transmitter output. This is the power output of the transmitter. This can be seen again in the specification sheet. For the total system gain, this is the overall combination of the gain. In here, we have the power output and 2x antenna gain. EIRP, or also known as effective isotropic radiated power. This is the overall combination of gains minus losses. The power output from the transmitter plus the gains minus all the losses. And now for the RSL, which is also the received signal level. This can be obtained by total system gain minus a total system loss. So for the fade margin, which is composed of the objective fade margin, the thermal fade margin, and the flat fade margin. So for the objective fade margin, using the formula of 30 log D, plus 10 log 6 ABF, minus 10 log 1, minus R, minus 70, where A is the roughness factor. If it is over water or very smooth terrain, A equals to 4. If it is an over an average terrain, A equals to 1. And if it is over a rough or mountainous area, A equals to 0.25. On the other hand, B is equivalent to the factor to convert a worse man probability to animal probability. If it is hot, humid, B equals to 0.5. If it is average inland areas, B equal to 0.25. And if it is very dry and mountainous, B is equal to 0.125. Thermal paid margin, which is simply equals to the minimum receiver threshold minus the receiver signal level. We can obtain the minimum received threshold by RSL minus FM objective. For the flat paid margin, this is equal to the negative 10 log of 10 raised to negative thermal paid margin over 10. We will enter a tunnel to get the equipment specification so that we can compute the reliability later. Objective is to obtain the ideal reliability of 99.999, which is 49%. Yippee! For the non-diversity, First, we compute for the unavailability, which is A times B times 10 raised to negative 5 times frequency over 4 times distance raised to 3 times 10 raised to negative plus fm over 10. Still, A is the roughness factor and B is the Boltzmann probability to annual probability. Then we can now compute for the reliability by 1 minus unavailability multiplied by 100%. We will use diversity if the 4-9 is not satisfied in the ideal reliability. So, first thing is using KQ with Terran roughness reliability. Again, we first compute for the unavailability where it is equal to KQ over S to the 1.3 times frequency raised to B times distance raised to C times 10 raised to negative effective FM over 10. Then again, the reliability is equal to 1 minus unavailability multiplied by 100%. The corresponding value for KQ is 1 is to times 10 raised to negative 8. B is 1.2, C is 3.5, and S is the standard deviation that is equal to square root of average squared minus average elevation. For the second part of the formula. Mamma mia! I don't know the pronunciation, but I will call it Biegun's Barnett. Like in the previous reliability, unavailability will be the first to consider, which is equals to 6 times 10 raised to negative 7, times C, times frequency, times distance, raised to 3, times 10 raised to the negative effective FM over 10. As you can see in the formula, variable C will be equal to CF, that is equal to 1 times standard deviation of 15.2 raised to negative 1.3. Lastly, you can get the reliability by 1 minus reliability multiplied by 100%.
Mario, papasaba kami nila Lovely at Gillian sa micro.
You can do it! Yippee! Yahoo! Here we